Okay, let's go down to the bottom here. By the way, this Friday's episode, I'm not sure. We will have to see in 15 minutes what I do in this in the episode on Friday. I am not sure yet. I'm not a big guy to celebrate things. At least not these kind of numbers. Okay. This works out. I can now remove the parts in the middle. Okay. Ah, man, this is nice. This is really nice. I'm a huge fan of modeling this asteroid. And I'm so glad that this is all possible again. I talked about that in the footage from yesterday, that I kind of want to, and I think I talked about that in another episode too, but I definitely want to return here and have the asteroid base as my main base. I kind of switched over to Station 76 because of the lag problems and all that stuff, but now that the lag problems are, yeah, basically over, or not over, but got a lot better, I could switch back to this station as the main base, or at least, don't know, as maybe when the planets come in, I change my mind and think that we should definitely live on a planet. I'm not sure. I definitely want to build a planetary base, sure. But I'm not too sure if I should use that as a main base. A planetary base would have to have something really special to get made into a main base. We don't know if we get new materials with it or something like that. That would be a thing. Planetary mining bases, we don't know, need special materials from. That could be interesting. We are speculating. It's so fun. I'm watching a lot of Fallout 4 speculation videos right now, and there is a whole kind of YouTube channel base that is now building up just around Fallout 4 speculations. I have the feeling there are channels that just speculate on upcoming games. Sometimes it is not even presenting real news, or hey, they added this and we have seen this and this and this in screenshots or in leaked footage or something like that. No, the whole thing is we think it could be like this, and that would be completely cool. And we are speculating that we will get these and this weapons because they, in one of the in 4 seconds of footage, you can see that there is. I will be really surprised in the end what of the stuff these people are talking about is right. And let's say I'm happy to get my speculations. I'm absolutely happy to see speculations, and I can only sit there and be, oh yeah, that would be all nice and so. But that there is a real YouTube community building just around speculations for upcoming games. That's amazing. That's absolutely amazing. People sitting there talking, and other people say that about Let's Players too. So people talking into their microphones, just playing a game. That's fascinating. But people speculating about making wild speculations about games that are not even out. That fascinates me, absolutely. Yeah, it's good. That absolutely fascinates me. It's fun. But on YouTube, you have so much of that stuff that even I, as a YouTuber, don't get is the wrong word, because I can absolutely understand that people want to know more about the upcoming games, and I'm doing that too. I'm watching a lot of the Fallout speculations. What could be in the game? What will be there? What time frame? How big is the map size? What weapons? How many cool weapons will be there? And I'm a big fan of that, because again, I can't wait for this game. I still have to pre-order it, but I definitely will do that. It's so amazing, Fallout 4. And sometimes there are videos where by the way, one big shout out, and the guys will never see that. I don't know. But one big shout out goes to Shoddycast. These guys make a weekly, very small podcast about that, where they give new information and have only a small section with wild speculations. These guys do amazing work there. Definitely a big shout out to these guys. Not that they would need a big shout out from a small guy like me. And it is definitely fun. I don't know what game I also did that. Yeah, for Minecraft, you always had these Minecraft discussions. What would be next? What could come next? And what would they next feature in the game? And. But I don't know. For what other game did I do that? I can't really remember. Fallout is one of the games I'm really, really waiting for. I'm really, really, really waiting for it. It's hard. This is like waiting for, I don't know. There's no comparison to waiting for Fallout. More steel. No. Steel plates. Do I need to order more? I definitely need to order more, I think. Okay, let's finish up the few on the bottom here. And then we can go and start to weld up the pillars. And maybe then put in the middle shaft and work our way around. There's definitely no other game I wait for so hard like Fallout 4. It. Let me. I like that there's this bit of material in front of it. I could also put in windows on the side then here. We will see. One thing I need to know is where the stairs end. That will be a big thing for me. Okay, I need more steel plates. Ah, there are more. Nice. Good thing. I will work in light armor here. The hangers always get the heavy armor plating or the heavy armor treatment, but the light armor here is good enough for all the personal sections. Okay. Let us see. I will have to hammer out a bit more material when it comes to the walls, but one thing I might want to know before is where does the staircase end? I wanted to try it in my head in the last recording, but that was not very successful. Okay, this and this. I'm not sure yet, by the way. I still have the idea of playing New Vegas, but I'm too afraid, and I would like to do it with Fallout 4, definitely. I'm not sure. I'm not sure. A lot of people tell me I should diversify my content. Diversify? Give a bit. Do some more content, kind of. To, don't know. The problem is, and I got a good tip from someone that is way bigger than me, and he said stay with the stuff you are doing, because it is, if you just go and bring one series after the next and then do another one, the people are not kind of, you don't get this identity of, okay, this guy is the space engineers or and StarMade let's player, and he said stay with the things you are doing for as long as possible, and if you have accumulated a good size on YouTube and all that stuff, then branch out, find new games to play and all that stuff. And I think I will do that. My problem right now is that I think I need to branch out at least a bit to maybe find new grounds for me. But we will see. I'm still waiting for the one game I want to have and want to play. It's so bad that the release date is still not set, and other people already had the chance to play demo versions. It angers me. Okay. This works out. Let me. We should maybe. I have an idea. Okay. This part is where the platform will be. Let us weld that up. So you can see the staircase ends here, and the platform will be there. So the next platform will be here. I'm trying to find out where the staircase ends. I will definitely do that right now. Next platform will be here. The next one will be here. And here. Okay, it ends definitely on this side. So the doorway and all that stuff will be here. I like that because it kind of lines up with this hole, but on the other hand, I would have liked it to have it here because it would kind of be more in the middle of the hangar, and I would have more space because now I can see if I want to add a small room on this side where, don't know, you can store spacesuits or whatsoever and then go into the hangar. But at least I know now that I can line up my walkways here. Okay, let's remove parts of this section here, I think. Or let me see. Let me reload my suit.